see her now, her withered skin, old straw hat and crooked grin. She says, child, let's make this garden grow. Let's till the soil and pull some weeds, and here's your bag of precious seeds. 'Cause grandma's got a secret you should know. You always reap exactly what you sow. Sow mercy, sow grace, sow kindness, sow faith. And words are like water sprinkled with love. You will harvest all your heart's been dreaming of. Sow mercy. We never.
Praise God, saints of God, praise God, hallelujah. Tunawasalimu nyote katika jina la Bwana. We greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ from wherever you are listening from. And we say welcome. Welcome again to this Sunday service that the Lord has given us. Psalm 118 verse 24 says, this is the day the Lord has made, and we are going to rejoice and be glad in it. So let us rejoice today together in the Lord, because he has given us another day so that we can rejoice in him. Hallelujah. So from wherever you are listening from, tunasema karibuni, karibuni sana. And I know that today the Lord is going to bless us together. So I was reminded of the blessings of the Lord, even despite what has been taking place. The Lord has been blessing us. There are people who are still graduating. There are people who are still getting married. There are those who have also gotten new jobs. There are those who have gotten new babies in the family, additions in the family. So the Lord is still blessing us despite what is going on. Let us count our blessings, and we count them one by one. There are those the Lord has given new houses. Hallelujah. So the Lord has been doing good and great things. But the devil wants us to look at the negative side. But today we choose to rejoice in him. Hallelujah. Amen. Because he's still on the throne. So let us open with a word of prayer as we continue with this service. And remember, we are counting our blessings one by one. And if we do that, you will see what the Lord has done for you. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's open with a word of prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we want to thank you. I want to bless you. For you have spoken to our hearts this afternoon through your word in Psalm 118 verse 24, that this is the day the Lord has made. You are the one who has made this day, that we should rejoice and be glad in it. And Father, today, this afternoon, we choose to rejoice in you, O God, because you have been good to us. Despite what has been taking place, Father, we have seen your blessings. We have witnessed of your healing. We have witnessed your deliverance in many situations. We have witnessed, my Father, your blessings in the land of the living. So we choose to rejoice today in you, O God. We want to thank you, Lord, for the week that has gone. You've been our keeper. You've been our protector. You've been our shield. You've been our defender. You've been our anchor, my Father. You have not failed in any way, because you are a faithful God. So you have seen us through, and we have come to say thank you, Lord. And even as we begin this service this afternoon, we want to come before you, my Father, and confess of our sins that are many that we have done. In your mercy, Father, we ask you to forgive us and wash us, Lord, with that blood that was shed on the cross for us. And Father, may the righteousness of your Son, Jesus Christ, cover us this afternoon. That when you look down on us, God Almighty, you only see the righteousness of your Son, Jesus Christ. And you can then come boldly before your throne to obtain mercy today. My Father, I want to lift up every listener from wherever they are listening. Oh God, oh hallelujah. Your power has no barrier. Your spirit has no barrier. It's my prayer today that the anointing of today will touch them wherever they are and meet them at their point of need. Whatever situation, my Father, they are going through, however, my Father, they are feeling today, because I know there are some who are sick. The others that are feeling low, the others are feeling forsaken, the others are feeling like heaven has closed for them. The others, Father, who are sorrowful. Today, my Father, let your word that is alive touch them from wherever they are, in the mighty name of Jesus. And it's my prayer, by the end of this service, you will have ministered to our heart, because that is why you gather your people together, so that you can bless them. Today, my Father, we partake of these blessings. We declare and decree they are ours and our children and their children, in the mighty name of Jesus. So as we come before you, my Father, I want to pray, Jehovah, King of Glory, that your anointing will touch us in a mighty way today. That your heart, your word will speak to our hearts today. That at the end of this service, oh God, we shall have a witness that we have been in the presence of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. I want to lift up your servant even as he comes to bring your word, oh God. This is just a vessel that you have chosen for such a time and for this generation. My Father, my God, I pray for your anointing today upon his life in the mighty name of Jesus. As he opens his mouth, oh God, it's no longer his mouth. The words that will come out of his word, my Father, his mouth will be your word. Your word that will come forth with the power, setting the captives free and blessing every listener. My Father, I cover him with the blood of Jesus, from the top of his head, the sole of his feet. And we declare today, my Father, you have called him, you have chosen him, you have mandated him to speak the word of God today with the power and authority. We also take authority as the children of the Most High God. We come against the accuser of the brethren. We bind every demonic power that may want to interfere with this service today. We render them powerless in the mighty name of Jesus. We destroy their camps and their altars in the mighty name of Jesus. And we call upon the fire of God to burn every evil from wherever the listeners are listening. Jehovah, let them be encompassed by your power. Let them be surrounded by your authority in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And so we declare today, my Father, that we are standing on holy grounds where Jesus Christ is Lord and worthy to be lifted up and to be glorified. Today we declare it's all about Jesus. Hallelujah. That is where we give you glory and we give you honor. My Father, it's my prayer that the blood of Jesus will cover us and cover the listeners from wherever they are listening from, and the angels of God will minister to each one of us. We give you glory, Lord, and we give you honor. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we have prayed, and the people of God say, amen and amen. Give a hand clap unto the Lord as we welcome the man of God to bring the word of God today.
Please turn with me to the book of Galatians. The book of Galatians, chapter 6, and let us read from verse 7. Galatians chapter 6, and I am reading from verse 7 onwards. Do not be deceived. God is not mocked. For whatever a man sows, that he will also reap. Let me read that again. Whatever a man or a woman sows, that he will also reap. For he who sows to the flesh will of the flesh reap corruption. But he who sows to the Spirit will of the Spirit reap everlasting life. And let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us also do good to all, especially to those who are of the household of faith. Bless the name of the Lord. Lord, I want to thank you for this word. I am asking that you guide me as I speak it. Let it bring life to all of us, O Lord. It is a blessing to those who are here and all those who are tuned in and those who will be tuned in later on. It is in Jesus' name I have prayed, and all say,
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Today's topic is an interesting one. The title of today's message is Mind Your Sowing. Mind Your Sowing. Or think or be concerned about your sowing. Be concerned about what you are planting, if I can put it another way. So that is the title, Mind Your Sowing. And I want to introduce this message with the words I was emphasizing in verse 7 of Galatians 6. The words read, whatever a man sows, that he shall reap. Whatever a woman sows, that she shall reap. Whatever anybody sows, that will they reap. Now, there is a law that governs the sowing and the reaping. The reaping follows the sowing. If you think of sowing grains like maize or beans, when you sow them into the soil, there is, of course, the reaping that is expected at the time of the harvest. Therefore, sowing and reaping, they constitute a law in this world and also in the spiritual world. It is a law that cannot be broken. Whatever we plant, if we plant maize, we are going to reap maize. If we plant beans, we are going to reap beans. It is a law and it is fixed. Hallelujah. It is like the gravity. The gravity, whether we like it or not, it still pulls us down. That is why we cannot fly. It is a law. I want you to see that it is a law. It is fixed. I cannot change it. You cannot change the law of sowing and reaping. Only God can temporarily stop that law. Particularly if people are disobedient. You remember, as you read the Bible, there were times God would actually intervene in that law of sowing and reaping. And people would sow, but God would intervene and say, because you have gone astray, you are not going to reap anything. That is an intervention, divine intervention. But it is still a law in this world. It is also a law in the spiritual world, as we are going to see. Now, the main question we are answering today is this. Is there a right sowing? And is there a right reaping? In other words, what you are interested in is this. What can I sow that is right in order to reap that which is good? That is the topic of today. The law of sowing and reaping. Now, therefore, at the end of this message, the Spirit of God will teach us what is right sowing and what is right reaping. That is the objective of this word. Now, first of all, we want to find out what is right sowing. What does it mean? And what is right reaping? What does it mean to us? Now, first, let's define what is sowing. You know, many times we think of sowing in terms of putting a seed in the ground. We think of a farmer planting seeds. We think of sowing a seed as it has been misused by so many people, as they tell people you must sow a seed. We tend to see sowing in that context, but that is a very narrow way of looking at sowing. Sowing is very big. Why? Because the meaning of sowing, it is acting. When you sow, you are doing an activity. You are engaged in some action. That is what is called sowing. What I do is sowing. Why we are here, we are sowing. When we came, we were sowing. It's an action. So don't look at sowing in a very narrow way and think of the people who keep on asking for a seed to sow in the ministry or something like that. No, that is a tiny bit of sowing. Sowing is every action that we take. That's the first thing we need to comprehend. It is the activities that I'm engaged in every day. Now, from the time we woke up until now, I'm telling you, we are still sowing. Because there is an action we are doing. And whenever we are doing any action, we are sowing something. That's the first thing we need to comprehend. The second thing is, the Bible, the Word of God, divides sowing and reaping into two groups. Let's start with the sowing. The verse I have just read for you in Galatians 6, verse 7, it says something about sowing. It says there is one type of sowing that is called sowing to the flesh. What does it mean to sow in the flesh? Because that's what that verse is saying. It says, whatever a person sows, they will reap what they have sown. And then it goes on to say, there are some who sow to the flesh, and they reap something out of that. So what does it mean to sow in the flesh? Because what we are after is to understand what is right sowing. According to this scripture we are reading, we don't need to go very far. It explains, number one, what is sowing? It is the activities we do. And secondly, it explains what is good sowing and what is bad sowing. What is good sowing? What is wrong sowing? What is good reaping and what is bad reaping? That's what we are going to find out from the scriptures. Now, the first thing we are told, as Paul wrote to the Galatians, we are told this, that there is a kind of sowing that sows to the flesh. What does that mean? Simply put, it means whatever I do and whatever you do according to our own will. Hallelujah. Amen. Anything I do according to my will, according to my desires, the desires of this flesh, if I do it, that is sowing to the flesh. If I do anything, for example, this morning, there are people who are involved in sowing in the flesh. Why? Because whatever activities they are doing right now, or the activities they have been doing, they are doing it according to their own will. It is what they want. It is what I want. It is aimed at satisfying me. It is aimed at satisfying the desires of this flesh. So we do it according to our will. That is what is called sowing to the flesh. Keep that in mind. Now, there is the other kind of sowing, the good sowing. When we sow to the flesh, that is bad sowing. It is wrong sowing, and we will know it is wrong sowing by the result. Now, it tells us, before we go to the good sowing, it says this, if I sow wrongly and I sow to the flesh, what is the outcome? What is the reaping? What am I going to reap out of it? It simply uses this word, if I sow to my flesh, if I sow according to my desires, if I sow according to my will, according to what I want, The word says this, out of that, I am going to reap corruption. Now, the word corruption, it covers a wide range of negative things. If I can put it simply, it means if I do according to my will, what I'm going to reap is a disastrous result. Hallelujah. What I'm going to get out of what I have done according to what I think, it is going to be disastrous. It is going to be negative. So that is why it is called wrong sowing. When you sow to the flesh, when you sow according to our will, that is wrong sowing, and the result, the reaping, is corruption. Now, corruption means the results are going to be negative. The results are going to be bitter. The results are going to be very troublesome. And at the end of it, it says, we will reap death. Now, death does not just mean physical death. It also means the second death that is explained in the book of Revelation. So that is bad sowing. It is wrong sowing. Whenever we sow something according to our will, whenever we do an action according to our will, that is wrong sowing. It ends in disastrous results here in earth and in the heavens to come. But there is the other side of good sowing. It is described there. And Paul puts it this way. The good sowing, the right sowing, is the sowing that is sown to the Spirit. Hallelujah. What does it mean to sow to the Spirit? It means whatever I do it to please God. In other words, whatever I do it according to the will of God. Not according to my will, but according to the will of God. So whenever I sow something and I'm guided by the will of God and my desire is to please the Spirit, my desire is to please God, that is called right sowing. But look, think about it. How many times are we doing things according to our will? We do things even without consulting God completely. We do things simply to please ourselves. Right now, millions and billions of people, they are involved in wrong sowing. Why? Because they are doing it according to their will. They are not doing it to please the Spirit. They are not sowing to the Spirit. They are not doing it according to the will of God. So the good sowing is when we do something, but we are doing it according to the will of God in order to please God or to please the Spirit. What is the outcome of that sowing? It is described there. The word eternal life is put there as the result. But eternal life is not the whole thing. When you sow according to the will of God, if you do something to please the Spirit of God who is guiding us, the result is positive. That is the point. The result is good. The reaping is good. The reaping is satisfactory. The reaping brings you contentment. The reaping is the blessings that we begin to experience when we sow right. Hallelujah. Amen. When we sow in order to please the Spirit of God, in other words, when we sow to the Spirit, the reaping is wonderful. It is glorious. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, having now understood what is sowing, sowing is activities that we do, any action we take. And then the next step is, that action I have taken, is it according to my will or is it according to the will of God? Is it according to my desire to please the Spirit of God or is it aimed at pleasing me? That is what makes the distinction between good sowing and wrong sowing. And you can see the result determine whether the sowing was right or wrong. This is why Paul says, if I sow to the flesh, if I sow according to my own desire, I will reap corruption. It means my result will be very bitter. My result will be negative. There will be a bitter pill to swallow. But if I sow to please the Spirit of God, the result will bless me. I will incur the blessing of the Lord here in earth and life eternal in heaven. Hallelujah. That is the difference. Now, having understood about this principle of sowing and reaping, we are going to make the following observations as I come to the end of this word. The first observation is that reaping is living with the consequences of our actions. When you talk about reaping, it is active. I am living with the consequences of what I have done. Now think about it. The consequences. The question we need to ask ourselves is this. Do we want to reap consequences that are going to cause us trouble? Consequences that are bitter to us. Consequences that cause sorrow to us. And consequences that will end up in corruption and death. Is that what we want at the end? That is a very important question. Whenever we are doing anything, that is the first thing we must consider. What kind of consequences do I want? Because living with the consequences is what is called reaping. There are many people today, they are living in those bitter consequences. Because we made decisions. And those decisions, they were not in line with the will of God. They were not in line with the word of God. They were not done with the objective of pleasing the Spirit. Therefore, many people are crying out. Because they are reaping difficulties. They are reaping sorrow. They are reaping consequences that are very, very difficult. And there is a lot of crying because of those consequences. So the understanding of the fact that reaping is living with the consequences, that should stop us from making any action or any decision that has nothing to do with the will of God. In other words, I begin to fear, this thing I want to do, what is it going to bring to me? Is it what God desires? Is it according to the will of God? Am I doing this in order to please the Spirit of God? Am I prepared to live with the bitter consequences of the decision I am just about to make? That's the first observation. That reaping is living with the consequences. What kind of consequences are you desiring to live with? Do you want to live with the bitter consequences? Then mind your sowing. That is the point. The second observation I have is, when we reap, when we begin to live with the consequences, we also reap in kind. What does that mean? Reaping in kind. Yes, it means this. If a farmer plants beans, what does he expect to get? Beans. If I plant maize, I expect to get maize. It is in kind. In other words, the outcome, the result is related to what I have planted. Hallelujah. Amen. So we reap in kind. Meaning this, if I sow to the flesh, I do not expect to see any goodness. Because I have to reap in kind. When I do actions that are not in line with the Spirit of God, then I cannot expect the blessings of God. That is why people are living lives that are very bitter. Because of sowing into wrong things. We reap in kind. The amazing thing is this. People are sowing to the flesh, and they are still expecting to experience the blessings of God. The blessings of God cannot come because of the law of reaping in kind. Because it's like we are saying, if I plant maize, I expect to find apples. That's what people are actually saying. If I plant beans, at the end of it, I'm going to get oranges. You can see it is impossible. And even in our lives, when we make decisions, if we are making decisions that are not in line with the will of God, we cannot reap good. We will only reap in kind the result which is corruption, the result which is death, the result which is very bitter, the result that brings out of sorrow and tears. So we reap in kind. Let us keep that in mind. We do not aim to do bad things and expect to make it to heaven. That is the mistake the world is making. They do things according to their will. And this business of saying there are many ways to God, it is just part of it. They are sowing wrongly, and they are still expecting to reach heaven. It is impossible. Because it is a law that when I plant beans, I must get beans. I cannot get oranges from maize. It is the same thing. Now, that's the second observation. The third one is reaping always exceeds the sowing. Let me explain that.
Amen.
You plant one seed of bean, or one seed of maize, and it gives you a cob filled with other maize seeds. I plant only one seed, I get many. Now, this is very important, that the reaping exceeds the sowing. The harvest always exceeds the planting. Because I plant single grains, maybe 10 grains, and out of 10 grains, I'm going to get thousands. Because if it is maize, you get a maize cob, it has several maize grains on it. Now, in the same way, in the spiritual kingdom, when we plant something to the Spirit, hallelujah, when we do one small act in order to please the Spirit, the blessings are multiplied. Amen. The blessings are so much we cannot contain them. Why? Because of this law that says that when you plant one seed, you get much, much more. In the Word of God, the Bible says, the things that God has prepared for his people, no eye has seen or ear heard, but they have been revealed to us by the Spirit. In other words, there are such great things that God has prepared, you cannot compare that with the deeds we are doing here. We are doing maybe single deeds according to the Spirit of God. The outcome, the reaping is so great that there is a good reason, yes, to aim at sowing right because of this principle, that reaping is much, much more than the sowing. But it works also on the other side. If I sow wrongly, now let me give you an example. If someone is married and they go and they commit adultery, they commit fornication, they commit sexual sins, that one sin is going to affect not that one individual who has committed it. Eventually, that mistake is going to cost maybe the marriage of that person. It will cause trouble to the children if there is a separation. In other words, it's like troubles are multiplied by only one mistake. There are people who engage in sexual sins, they get sick. When they get sick, then they bring the responsibility of caring for them to the families who should be doing something else. In other words, whatever activity we do, it may be only a single activity, but the reaping is much, much more. We have to keep that in mind. When you know that, you are careful not to make a mistake and do the wrong kind of sowing. That's another observation. There is also another observation I want to share with you. The time aspect of the law of sowing and reaping. You know that the farmer goes to plant seeds. He doesn't go the following day to harvest. He waits for a long period tending the farm, clearing the weeds until the time of the harvest. There is a time aspect in this law of sowing and reaping. Jesus planted a seed many years ago. He is still waiting for the harvest. Hallelujah. The harvest is still not yet. Why? Because the sowing is still going on. Today we are sowing. Hallelujah. We are sowing today. And you people and those who are listening, God is going to use you to sow more seeds. Until the time of the harvest. And Jesus is going to reap the result of what he planted. Hallelujah. Amen. He sowed a good seed.
Amen.
And because of that good seed, he is expecting a glorious harvest. Hallelujah. He is waiting for the reaping. And you know the book, the Bible is full of the end times, talking about the time of reaping. So that is another aspect we must keep in mind, because we sometimes complain many times, Lord, I have been doing this for you. I have been a good person. I have been serving you for many years. But Lord, I have not seen any kind of harvest. When am I going to reap? Let us remind ourselves of this law, that there is a time aspect. And that time aspect in spiritual matters is determined by the living God. Amen. He knows the right season. Amen. He knows the right time. It shall not be forever.
Amen.
That we are not reaping the good we have been planting. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is something that we need to hold on to. And this is actually the topic Paul is talking about. We talk about do not faint, as Paul says. We talk about do not be weary of doing good. What is Paul talking about here? He is talking about the sowing and the reaping and the time that it takes for the seed to grow. So he says this, when you sow, do not be weary of waiting for the reaping time. Do not be weary of waiting for the harvest. Keep on waiting for it. Notice he also continues to say, as you have opportunity, continue to do good. In other words, continue to sow good. And he says, because in due season determined by the Lord, you will reap. Hallelujah. That is what we are all waiting for. This is to encourage many who feel like they have been serving God for years. They have been faithful. I told you, we have been faithful in giving to the Lord. We started giving to the Lord many years ago.
Yeah.
And even today, we still give. Many of you don't know that even here, we still give, just like you do. But it took so many years until when we were here is when the Lord said, it is time to reap. Let me encourage you and tell you, it may take 5 years. It may take 10 years, 15 years, or 20. But the promise is sure and definite. A time will come and you will reap what you have been planting. Continue planting. Continue sowing goodness. And this is why Paul is saying, Do not be weary of doing well. Do not be weary of sowing good, because in due season you shall reap. And finally, there's one more point, one more observation that is very important I want to mention. This law of sowing and reaping, there is something that is inside that law that tells us that you reap according to the measure of your sowing. Hallelujah. The word says, if I sow sparingly, I reap sparingly. It is the law again. But let me clarify this. I am not talking about the sowing so many people talk about when they want money. I do not walk along that line. I am talking about the activities that we do.
Yes,
Lord. So when you talk about giving tithe and offering, that's a very tiny portion of the sowing we are talking about. In any case, let me tell you something about tithing and sowing. It is not how much we give that counts. It is the spirit in which it is given.
Amen.
I can give so much, but my spirit is not right. I am grumbling. I am giving it grudgingly. But what did Jesus say? The spirit of giving should be, he said, when you give, give cheerfully. Give cheerfully. There are people in this place, in this church, they give a lot, but they give cheerfully. That is the spirit that should govern our giving. In any case, do you remember Jesus pointing out a poor woman as he was watching the people giving their tithes and offerings? And he noticed everyone was showing how much they give, but this poor woman, she came with the 2 coins, and secretly she did not want anybody to see what she was giving, and she threw it into the box. And Jesus immediately singled her out. He told the disciples, let me tell you something. This woman had given much more than those who have given so much. Why? Because this woman gave everything she had cheerfully. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is the key to giving and receiving a blessing from God. When the spirit of giving is right, when we give cheerfully, in the same way in sowing, when we are doing deeds, as we do good, the same word applies. We do it cheerfully, not with a bitter heart, not with a heart that is not free to let go. It is the same rule that governs activities that we do for the Lord. We do them with zeal. We do them cheerfully. Hallelujah. In concluding this word today, I want to leave ourselves with this word. Mind your sowing. Think about your actions. And the question we must ask ourselves is this. Is this according to the will of God, or is it according to my will? It will be determined by what are you expecting to reap. If you are expecting a positive reaping, then sow to the spirit. Leave the work of the flesh alone and begin sowing to the spirit. The blessings will be yours in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Let's say a quick prayer and then we can leave. Heavenly Father, we bless your name because of this word of encouragement, encouraging us to continue sowing good, O Lord. Today we are asking that you energize us, you revitalize us, you renew us, O God. Give us a new zeal to do good, to sow without sparing in your work, O Lord. For your word tells us that we should not be weary of doing good. We should not be weary of sowing good. Help us this day, O God. to continue sowing good, because the reaping is going to be wonderful. It is going to be glorious. It is going to be satisfactory. And at the end of it, we reap eternal life. Lord, I release your blessings upon your people. Let your blessings follow and overtake them everywhere they go. Lord, I pray that you will shelter us. Even from this COVID-19, Father, let your hand be there to shelter us. Let your precious blood then cover every seed against this virus, O Lord. We pray, my Father, that this week will be a unique week as we continue with zeal to sow the good to the glory of your name. Lord, everyone who is listening and is in kind of a struggle, Lord, I speak a breakthrough to them. I speak healing to everyone who is sick in Jesus' name. And those who have been hit by the COVID-19, I call upon the name of the Lord of hosts, and I set you free. Be healed where you are. For the blood of Jesus Christ is more powerful than COVID-19. Yes. And I declare that you are healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I know there are people who are reaping bitter things because of past events, past sowing that was not right. Lord, I'm asking for your intervention today. I'm asking that you divert everything. Break the curse upon these people. Begin to do good to them, my Father, for today they know, they have understood the principle of sowing and reaping. Lord, I am asking that everyone who has been living in bitterness because of decisions made in the past that were not right, Lord, I'm asking now for your intervention. I'm asking that you begin to wipe away their tears. I'm asking, Lord, that you begin to do good to them and direct them to do the right sowing to the glory of your name. Lord, I thank you for this day. It is in Jesus' name I have prayed and all say, amen, amen. And God bless you for coming. God bless you for listening, those who are tuned in and those who will be tuned in. In Jesus' name.